How are you all doing today? Good? Great. So we're going to learn about character traits today. Do any of you know what character traits are? Jean?
Something you use to describe yourself.
Yeah. So in our own lives, traits are something we use to describe ourselves. Like, what would you describe yourself as?
Cool.
That's awesome. How about you, Carolyn?
Outgoing.
That's a good one. Adriana?
Helpful.
Yeah, that's awesome. So the same words that you just said, we can use to describe characters in books. So character traits are words used to describe a character's personality and how they act during certain situations. So we can use words to figure out what a character is like and how they're going to act in the story, which will help us understand the story better. So today, we're going to look at this list of character traits, and then we're going to read a short paragraph from the book To Kill a Mockingbird, and we're going to try and identify these character traits in the passage. So before we get started, are there any words on this list that you don't understand or you haven't heard before? Yeah, Adriana.
Sharp-witted.
So sharp-witted means clever or someone who's very smart. Yeah, Jean.
Shiftless.
So someone who's shiftless is lacking ambition. Any other words? Okay, great. So this is the passage that we're going to look at. Can I have a volunteer to read it? Carolyn, thank you. Go ahead.
When he was nearly 13, my brother Jem got his arm badly broken at the elbow. When it healed and Jem's fears of never being able to play football were
assuaged,
he was seldom self-conscious about his injury. His left arm was somewhat shorter than his right. When he stood or walked, the back of his hand was at right angles to his body, his thumb parallel to his thigh. He couldn't have cared less so long as he could pass and punt.
Great job reading. Thank you. So, looking at this passage and looking at the list of character traits we have, what can we identify about Jem? Yeah, Carolyn.
I think he's self-confident because the passage says he was seldom self-conscious about his injury.
Yeah, that's great. So, even though his left arm was shorter than his right arm, he didn't care and he just walked how he had before he got hurt. And this shows that he's confident even though he had an injury. Anyone else? Is there another word that jumps out? Yeah, Adriana.
I would say he's tough because even though he got injured, he kept playing football after.
Yeah, that's great. And we can even see that Jem was afraid of never being able to play football even after he badly broke his arm. So he has to be really tough to be able to get back into a sport where he could get hurt worse than he had already. That's a great one. Jean, do you have any words that you think can describe Jem?
I think he's pretty determined, because at the last sentence, he didn't even care if he hurt himself, but he kept going because he wanted to play football.
Yeah, that's great. So he couldn't have cared less so long as he could pass and punt. So really, the most important thing to him was getting able to play football again. So he's extremely determined to make sure that that's what he was going to be able to do. Great. So just from this short paragraph, we were able to identify three different traits about the character Jem from this book, To Kill a Mockingbird. So I've created a chant for all of you that will help you learn how to remember how to identify character traits when you're reading books in the future. I'm going to do it first, and then we can all do it together. Characters do things. They feel, they hear, they speak. Characters do things, like perform activities. When characters do things, we can find all of their traits and understand who they are, the identity they create. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, great. Let's do it all together on the count of three. Ready? Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3.
Characters do things, they feel, they hear, they speak. Characters do things, like perform activities. When characters do things, we can find all of their traits and understand who they are, the identity they create.
That's great. Thank you all so much for being so active in today's lesson.